Last night was the Iowa debate between Ron DeSantis, Nikki Haley on CNN. It was moderated by Jake Tapper and Dana Bash. And I'm going to give you my quick thoughts about it. I'm going to try not to drag this out too long like I've done with previous videos because there's really not too much to talk about. Overall, I think it was a draw between these two candidates. They had some W's, L's. They drew blood on each other a few times throughout the Iowa debate. Nikki continued to promote DeSantisLies.com. A few times would have been fine, but she did it so many times that she started sounding like a parrot. And I don't think that it had the effect that she was hoping, especially since she did it a lot. And it just got annoying as hell. So yeah, that didn't exactly help Nikki Haley by repeatedly saying DeSantisLies.com, DeSantisLies.com. It was just very, very tiresome to hear. I think if she'd have peppered it in like maybe a half a dozen times throughout the debate, that'd been one thing. But it was easily four or five times that amount. DeSantis actually had his best performance in the presidential debate, in my opinion, thus far. For the most part, the previous debates, he's been somewhere in the middle. You know, he hasn't been the worst. He was far from the best. But he actually had a pretty decent night versus Haley. Now, just because I think he had a great night debating Haley compared to his past few debates doesn't necessarily mean he won. Like I said a moment ago, overall, a draw. They each got some W's and some L's, and yeah, they definitely drew blood and had some fireworks back and forth. Along with promoting DeSantisLies.com, Haley called DeSantis a liar on numerous occasions and criticized some things he's done as governor of Florida, but I think that near the end of the debate, that actually comes back to bite her on the ass. We'll get to that in a moment. Both questioned each other's tenure and record as governor. Haley, formerly governor of South Carolina. DeSantis, currently governor of Florida. Both also tried to not get too critical of Trump. They got somewhat critical of him on a few occasions. And often when they were asked about Trump's record or something regarding Trump, Haley would deflect and would say this: he should be here to defend his record. But there was some criticism, but not to the point where they wanted to obviously upset the MAGA supporters. Both Haley and DeSantis were like going to the very edge of criticism, but trying not to cross a line. Because in reality, Haley and DeSantis are fighting for second place, the backup quarterback position, should Trump be forced out of the race through legal or health issues. Neither wants to anger the MAGA supporters in the hopes that they'll win over some or most of those supporters in a hypothetical post-Trump 2024 race on November 5th. It's not because they're afraid of Trump, it's that they see that huge group of MAGA supporters behind Trump, still loyal as hell. And they're thinking, if I somehow get the GOP nomination, if something happens to Trump, I want those MAGA supporters on board with me going into the November election. The best way to do that is by not upsetting the MAGA apple cart too much. Yeah, MAGA at the moment doesn't exactly like DeSantis or Haley. They might like DeSantis a little bit more between the two, but at the same time, they don't want to completely piss off MAGA supporters. But overall, who was the winner? Now, I said that it was a draw between Haley and DeSantis, but there was a winner. You're probably asking yourself, GB, how can there be a winner if you said that it was mostly a draw between these two candidates? Well, it definitely was a win for Trump because he has a commanding lead still in all the polls against DeSantis and Haley. And at the same time, he was attending a town hall on Fox. I think that the ratings actually went in the debate's favor. So I think that the town hall debate didn't do as well ratings-wise versus the Iowa debate between DeSantis and Haley. At least that seemed to be the case last night because the debate was trending much higher than Trump's town hall. Despite that, I still believe that Trump won the debate. He avoided battle once again on the debate stage. It continues to work in Trump's favor. If he would have attended the debate, where it would have been basically a two-on-one battle, well, sometimes maybe a three-way, but it would have been an opportunity for DeSantis and Haley to show Republicans and even MAGA supporters that Trump is not the same Trump from 2016 or 2020. Attending last night's debate would have seriously hurt Trump in the polls. So yeah, I think that despite the best efforts by DeSantis and Haley in the Iowa debate, Trump still technically won. Now, there was a conclusion to the debate that I did want to go over that I found very interesting, which could actually tip the debate towards DeSantis over Haley. CNN asked, what do you admire the most about your opponent? And the opponent were the two opponents on the stage, DeSantis v. Haley. DeSantis talked highly about South Carolina. He mentioned how it's a great state. I believe his wife is from South Carolina, or their family is. He also said that while she was UN ambassador, Nikki Haley did some things that DeSantis actually agreed with. And then when Haley was asked the same question about DeSantis, she had this look on her face that I can only describe as reluctance to say what she ended up saying. And this, I think, did not help her. Quote unquote, I think he's been a good governor. But she spent the entire debate criticizing DeSantis as governor of Florida, as well as calling him a liar and promoting that website. It seems to contradict what Haley was saying about DeSantis as governor throughout the entire debate by calling him a good governor. So I don't really feel like Haley won that one. Closing arguments by both candidates were decent. Haley said, we can't go through four more years of chaos. I agree with that, whether it's the Trump chaos or Biden chaos. I'm sick and tired of the political chaos that's been running rampant in this country. She also claimed to have defeated Biden by 17 points in recent polling. I don't know if that's true or not. And she believes that our best days are to come. DeSantis said, I'm running for your issues to put America people first. I'll get the job done and will not let you down. Haley also talked about earlier in the debate how she wants to make America proud again. DeSantis wants to engineer a comeback for this country. And DeSantis was very critical about Haley with her past dealings with China as governor of South Carolina, along with being a corporatist or pro-corporations and a globalist. Best thing that Haley would do is just once again accuse DeSantis of being a liar. Well, he's a politician. What else is new? You're both liars to a certain degree. But overall, the debate itself was okay. I guess it was good to actually have like a 1v1 Lincoln Douglas style debate instead of everyone else on the stage, especially candidates that have even less of a chance. It's definitely been whittled down since the first debate, which had a whole bunch of presidential candidates on the stage. Ramaswamy not happy that he wasn't included. And Chris Christie, hours before this debate kicked off, suspended his campaign. I talked about that yesterday. He also had a hot mic moment where he was critical of both DeSantis and Haley, talking about how Haley is going to get smoked and how DeSantis is petrified. Coming up next is the Iowa caucus. I will go over the Iowa caucus results, just like I'm going to do with the rest of the primaries. Iowa caucus, New Hampshire primary, Super Tuesday in March, etc. And the next debate, also hosted by CNN, will be the New Hampshire debate on January 21st. Is it going to be part two of DeSantis versus Haley? Or will one of these candidates bow out before that debate, depending on how the Iowa caucus goes? I guess we'll just have to wait and see. By the way, thank you so much for getting the channel over 800 subscribers. I do have a prediction poll up that I'm interested in you voting in. Who do you think will win the Iowa caucus? Trump, Haley, DeSantis, or Ramaswamy? Feel free and go cast your vote. Your thoughts, views, and opinions regarding the Iowa debate or how Trump did during the town hall that was airing around the same time. Whatever you wish to talk about. As always, welcome below in the comments section.